on, maybe the shoes, maybe the team, maybe the camp, maybe the crew. You need a win, who need a win, that's all we do. I've been a king and I've been about mine, never could doubt mine, they running the route, I leave them outline when I hit them. Drills and working the wheel where you're grinding at. You know what it be. Playing this here for the keeps. Had to make out with a feast. A family to feed. Third call where the trophy should be. EA got me in the game now. Redine with the gang now. They're hearing with a lane now. My home second with a rain now. Legendary on the field. Kind of drip is a skill. It's the highest cruise of bill. Ain't nothing to the heel.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt blue sheets through the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins. And the world's suspended, I told them. What I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on the 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Dallas Cowboys. It's a tradition that began in 1966, and off we go on a Thanksgiving afternoon in Dallas. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Fourth four receivers now. Three to the right, one to the left. Second down and four. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. 57, Mike, 57. They'll run with Elliott. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. Not at all what they envisioned on third down, 3 yards in the wrong direction. Now Jordan Berry on to kick this one away. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. So that'll be marked down as a 19-yard punt. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. About a little too aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag did come out.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and six.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4 yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
From the 35 on second down, Wentz, he'll fire deep for Rager. And that one falls incomplete, a 50-50 ball. A little dangerous, could have been picked. Now it's third down.
I like what they did there because many of the deep throws we see in the course of a game come to the outside, the perimeter of the field. In this case, they used the slot receiver to run deep downfield and tried to connect that way. Unsuccessful in that attempt, but I like what they were doing.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. 5 yards on the screen, but that'll take us to fourth down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Now this will make it into the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a 2-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs. So they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. looking to throw. Prescott. Eagle pressure. Too much this time. Down he goes. It's Ryan Kerrigan getting the sack.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
And that is incomplete.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over-game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
Barry on to punt as he gets this one away. Returnable for Thomas. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50. First and 10. Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. From midfield, here's Wentz. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
Philadelphia.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line.
Trayvon Diggs
getting the tackle.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Wentz on the give to Sanders. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need 6 on third down to keep the drive going. Now Wentz on third down. Got a man. He finds Sanders. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11.
And an Eagles first down.
Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And he'll get 4 there, down to about the 12-yard line.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
They'll come out in a 4-receiver look. 3 men to the right side on 2nd and 6. Shotgun now for Wentz. And it's incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
It's 3rd down and 6 yards to go.
Play of the drive upcoming here on 3rd and 6. From the gun, it's Wentz. He's going to drop this down to Sanders.
And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the five at the four. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
Touchdown.
Miles Sanders with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. And his kick is no good. It's an early miss. We'll see if that has any ramifications later here as the afternoon wears on. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
We often give credit to the O-line. There, two tight end formation. Those tight ends block pretty well also.
Yeah, and that's one of the most dynamic positions in football now. The tight ends who can block at the line of scrimmage at the point of attack, and they can also get downfield and catch the football.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Taken down.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On second and 9, Prescott.
He'll find Lamb. That's complete.
And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 45-yard line.
He missed on his first three passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection. Maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you're wondering, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion. They think he might be off to the races.
Kill, kill, kill.
They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
A gain of 4. It's now second and 6.
After 1, it's 9-0.
With the score, Eagles 9, Cowboys nothing.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
Second down at 6 now from the 42.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, Keith. Right there, 54, right there, right there.
Now Elliott. He's going to get this inside the 30. 12 yards there and a first down. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the 4th overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Inside the 20 before he's brought down. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
19-yard line.
First opportunity in the red zone for the Cowboys. First and 10 at the 19. Run for Pollard. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys have cut it to within a score. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. And each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They start on the ground here at Sanders. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6.
Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
Back-to-back 4-yard runs. Now look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now third and 2, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. The Eagles on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. Working from the gun, Wentz. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
It's a return of 4 following a 42-yard punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25.
57, Mike, 57. Push him back. Push him back. Jim, 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 Jim.
Prescott to throw it. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. Here's Prescott. Going left side, it's complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Catch number 44 on the year. It's a 1st down. Throw again. Prescott. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Elliott. Now the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
It's a gain of 8.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On second down, it's Elliott, and he's going to take this close to the first down marker as he stopped at the Eagles' 38. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
First and 10 at the 38.
Prescott on first down. And he finds a man on a crossing route. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Give him 18 on that one, and it's a Dallas first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
By Dak, complete out wide, and he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19. Now those linemen, of course, can't be more than a yard downfield when a pass is thrown, and they might have been able to call that on a couple of guys there. Prescott now. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Ryan Kerrigan in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2-minute warning. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Here's Elliott, and the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Just a 1 yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
So now on fourth down, Mike McCarthy will turn to his field goal unit. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And this is off the left upright, and it comes back. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So distance not the issue there. He had plenty of leg to get it there. It's that darn upright getting in the way.
Always gets in the way of a good time, doesn't it? Because he hit it square, too. Sometimes you can bank one in if you get it on the end of the football. No such luck there for him.
On first down, Wentz. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
What's easy to see when we review this, that the ball needs to come out quicker, because if you don't throw it right on the break, you bring a crowd of people into the equation.
And that's why it got knocked away there. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Play fake to Sanders. Now here's Wentz. And complete to Zach Ertz. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. On third down, they'll run it with Sanders. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
Important to do, especially early in the game like they have.
Brings up second and five.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Here's Wentz to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. That catch good for five. It's third down. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. They'll try and run for it with Sanders. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
Three on the play. First down, Philadelphia.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Now, I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it. It costs your team.
Wentz now on first down. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Now let's see who this is on. And since the penalty occurred in the end zone, move the ball to the 1 yard line.
First and goal from the 1 yard line. Costly penalty.
Now Wentz will keep it. And no signal, but I don't think he got the surge behind center. No, he's going to be kept out of the end zone. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And his kick here is good. So a late three there, and that'll help as they head into the break.
Talk about situational football and something they've worked on since the OTAs and minicamps the previous summer. They take care of the ball, get 3 points, knowing they're going to get the ball to start the second half. That's the old two-for-one special to finish things off.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
So we've hit halftime on Turkey Day here in Dallas. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. And the half will begin with a touchback. And the Eagles now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He'll start with a handoff to Sanders. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Sanders, the Eagle.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
From the 30 on second down, Wentz. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete.
Wentz's pass.
Given three on the screen. He couldn't break free, and it's third down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Third down, they turn to Sanders, and he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Now flags come in here. Looked like one of the Eagles might have moved. A full start backs him up five, first and 15. They fake the give. Now Wentz. This ball complete to Rager. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. And it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Boys, 42 yard line.
On second and 11 now. Wentz. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
A run on first down that won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard. Second and 11.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. A quick throw into the hands of Rager. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12. Going to throw. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up fourth. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. And his kick is right there. It's good. And that now makes this a 15-7 game. So three field goals that he's hit. Now this last one helps him stretch out the lead.
He's been solid, hasn't he? And he lives up to the adage that every offensive coach has ever said to us. We want to end every possession with a kick, right? For them, it's either extra point, field goal, or at worst, a punt. In this case, it's been threes.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. On second and nine, Prescott. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Complete to number 13. A gain of two brings up third and seven.
36, 57, Mike 57. Ricky. Slam. And 47.
Prescott from the gun. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass or run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Sanders. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
And an Eagle first down.
They'll run. It's Sanders. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
Final minute now of the third quarter. On second and 11 now, Wentz. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To throw is Wentz. He may try and run for this. The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
Just wide of that left upright, it's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Well, he was 3 for 3 to that point, but he couldn't keep the perfect game going.
Did someone mention it on the bench and jinx
Maybe
it?
Maybe jinx him a little bit.
Well, you doubt it had anything to do with overconfidence, but hey, it's an inexact science. These things do happen.
Now, meanwhile, a final play here is incomplete, and that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter of play.
We're on to the fourth here on Thanksgiving Day. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Now Prescott. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
And normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
The Cowboys on third down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And that will be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Jordan Berry now as he's on to punt for Dallas. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return, and out will come the offense as they take over. The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Looking for Rager again. This time he's got him. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
A gain of 4, and it's third down.
Wins. Man open, it's J.J. Arcega-Whiteside. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
A gain of 2 yards.
2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. .46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. 47 yards on the punt that time, just 1 yard on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Gun. Here's Prescott. And he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper.
Complete.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Brings up second down at the 18-yard line.
To throw again on second down. Prescott. And he's got Cooper on the out route. That's complete. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now Pollard. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage, and now third and 11 coming up.
Third and 11.
Can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
It's fourth down.
Dak and the offense still out there. They are going to go for it.
Let's make these babies cry on the way back home.
The Cowboys will go. Prescott letting one fly deep for Cooper. And no, it's incomplete. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Number 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers. Fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for 4-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. Now third down is looming. A pickup of 2 on first down and just 1 yard there.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
The Eagles on third down. They've hit on half of them, 5 for 10. This will be third and 6. Twins. Open man, it's Rager. He's got it. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Wentz on target to Rager. First down, Eagles.
First down, Eagles.
Now a carry for Sanders. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown.
Miles Sanders, the ball carrier.
Miles Sanders. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles add on to their lead. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. And it wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
The Cowboys take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points. So he rifles one that's intercepted.
picked off at the 36. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the 1 yard line. A great pick, nice return, but you know he's just beating himself up inside for not getting all the way in.
No doubt about it, because he had visions of end zone in his mind, going to be the total hero, but we did see there the emphasis on it's not just good enough to pick it off anymore. Bring it back, get the yardage, and really help out your offense.
It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll make it second and goal.
At the 2 yard line.
Here comes Sanders on the toss right. And that play's not going to get him in as he stopped right at about the line of scrimmage. They try to get the nose of the football across to no avail, and now it's third and goal. They'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. They'll try to run with Sanders, and this time he is in.
Yes. The ball carrier.
Touchdown. Miles Sanders, his third touchdown of the game, 10th on the year. And the Eagles take advantage of good field position on the turnover to cash this one in.
Makes the score Eagles.
Extra point right down the middle. And the lead opens up now to 22 points. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards right off the bat for the first down.
At the 41-yard line.
So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 26 big yards on that one. It's another first down. Prescott. Wide open receiver complete. And they move this all the way down to the 9. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. And again, it's Prescott. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Harrison Smith. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. 30. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD.
That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. This one certainly has not gone according to script. You would have thought on paper that this offense would have its way here, but they certainly have not, and they trail big. After this, it figures to be a quiet trip home. To it after the pick six, Prescott. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Looking to throw, Prescott. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. And Prescott, his third interception. He's picked off near his own 48. For this defense, CeeDee, that's kind of the icing on the cake here as we get to the end of this one.
And didn't you feel that they weren't just going into total prevent there? You know, they had the lead, and sometimes you fall back and you lose your aggressiveness. Not in this case. They were still making a play on the football, and look how that one turned out. They may have salted this one away.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
I know you're trying to wring every yard out of a run, but I think 9 yards there is ideal in this situation.
Yeah, now next couple plays, you only need 1 yard. Keep that clock rolling with a lead here in the fourth.
Yeah, what you're saying is maybe if it takes you one or two more runs to get the first down, that's extra time, extra plays. It really hurts the team on defense.
They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now third and three. So fly, Eagles, fly. It's a victory for Philadelphia. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and, hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for the Eagles, the win gets them a step closer to 500 at 5-6. And now they'll have a few extra days here before they face Miami next week. Meanwhile, for Dallas, it's a loss that could hurt them come playoff seeding time as they drop to 8-3. And they'll try to rebound next week on the road in Washington. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Spin the block around just like the hands on the clock. Come like a bat of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like I'm finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best, if it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess, you ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, like cheetah, run up and I'm air in the scene. Not just like Vegeta, Prince, and I'm an heir to the seat. I mean, for real. Test the driver's saw so I don't even grab the wheel. That's a lot on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose thing, the freshman ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break a bone, me and myself top two. I blow away the competition like a ball of hot soup. And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the car, my dash. I shake a pick, told them all, you ain't first, you last. Little boy, that's facts, I'ma throw that cash to my money.
Let me stop. They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yo, look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come on, call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
Got a reflux, I drip out from the socket to a teacup. Drink up inside, look when it beep us. Cue us in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black hawk, see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising, thinking. What type of knowledge don't sink in? Life gives you lemons and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage. Way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze. On each and every way, put me in the water.
Change.